Here is the first true motion picture ever made.
Video creation has come a long way since the very beginning, and today marks another very important milestone. Runway just came out with Gen 2. This is a new AI magic tool that you can use directly inside Runway using text to create video, essentially making video out of thin air. So in this video, I'm going to be going over how to use it and my first impressions using this new feature, so let's dive in. But before we dive in, I just want to say, leave a comment down below. What do you think of Runway Gen 2 as I show you the different features and as you experiment on your own? All right, let's dive into Runway. All right, so I'm in Runway ML here, and the area you want to go to is just be sure that you click on Generate Videos to the left side, and then you'll see the new Gen 2 text to video feature. When you click on it, it'll go to this window where you can type in your text prompt. So just to show you, I'm going to start off simple here, you know, ocean, water, and you click the generate button in the bottom right, and it will create a video based on that text prompt. All right, so now once it's done, you'll see a 4-second video load. You can click play to preview it, and as you can see, it just created this video of water just based from that text prompt that I gave it. So this is a very simple example, but let's try to make it more complicated. All right, so let's go extreme here. Let's really add some descriptions and see what happens. All right, so let's change this to maybe a cat swimming in the water wearing sunglasses at night. Now, there's a few other options here. In the bottom left, you can click on interpolate. This will just make it smoother. You also have options to upgrade and then upscale, you know, if you wanted to export this out at a higher resolution. But for now, I'm gonna leave that checked, and let's click generate and see what happens here. It will vary how long it takes to accomplish this. So on average, it seems like it takes like 1 to 2 minutes maybe. But it might also depend how complicated the text, you know, prompt is for how long it takes to generate. But 1 to 3 minutes seems to be how long it takes to generate the new video based on the text prompt. All right, so now we have this. This looks freaky, man. But yeah, he's not really swimming. And it's a little dark too. But yeah, you can see the cat wearing sunglasses and you got water in the background. So pretty good. The only thing it didn't really do is swimming. It's not necessarily swimming so much. But yeah, there you go. I mean, that's crazy. You know, there's no way that you could actually, you know, get stock footage of that, of a cat wearing sunglasses, at least that easily. All right, so one other option that you have is that you can actually upload an image that Runway uses to help generate the video. So you'll see at the very bottom right, there's this little image section. So you can click on this and upload, drag and drop a file as well to upload an image. So I just brought in a Shutterstock image here of a nice sunset with some nice coloring. So I want a new video, stock video, to use this image as kind of like the style to create it. So what I'm gonna do is just click open. This will upload to Runway. All right, so now that it's uploaded, we can see it's uploaded in the bottom right corner. We can retype our text prompt. So maybe I want a new stock video of maybe a skyline, maybe like a city skyline, but it's in the style of that image. What I can type in here is city skyline and then click generate, and it should create a new video based on that style that I uploaded. Wow, this is interesting. So you can see it copied the style really well, but for some reason I added like a heart thing. It's very interesting. You just never know what you're gonna get when you type in a prompt here. You can just click generate again and it will create a new fresh image as well. Say if you didn't like the heart in the skyline. I don't know why it added a heart, but it did. But once we click generate, it should generate a new version of that if you wanted to experiment and see another option. Now this is pretty cool. So it also added some of the palm trees, that's what they're called, to the skyline as well. So it took some from the image and then added in a skyline, city skyline underneath. So that's a pretty cool option. Now also, if you wanted to download this to use, you can click the download button in the top right, and this will download to your downloads folder. Now just to mention, you know, it's lower resolution, so, you know, If you wanted to upgrade, you can click on this button in the bottom left, and then there's an upscale option where you can choose upgrade, and then you can choose to upgrade if you wanted to pay to get like a higher resolution. You'll also notice that you can only generate so many. So at the top right, you can see that, you know, I have 33 seconds left. And if you look back at this video, it's slowly counting down. So, you know, I think each video is 4 seconds. So if you do the math, that's, you know, I think maybe bad at math. So about 8 more times that I can probably generate a new video using the free version. So let's generate some other things and see what happens. Polar bear wearing a sombrero. Let's see what this will look like. Oh, wow. It completely, like, it's like a stuffed animal. I was expecting more like a real polar bear here. He has like 3 eyes. All right, let's do some action here. Let's see if it can do something, you know, like something running, maybe a horse running down a highway with cop cars chasing it. Something interesting.
Yeah, it didn't do it. It
shows horses like on the highway and like a car kind of like running into the horse. So I'm noticing a trend here with the, and I still have the image. It's still referencing the image. I didn't realize that. Okay, let's remove the image and see what happens here. All right, now we're gonna click generate. Hopefully this will be a little bit better. But I am noticing a trend that the more prompts you give it, it seems like it struggles a little bit more to get all the different things in. Okay, here we go. We got something interesting here. It's like a horse car. Wow. Well, you see like in the top right, there's horses running, and then in the bottom left, you have a car and like the tires are like horse legs. So yeah, it seems like it does simple prompts a lot better than like complicated prompts. So if you're going to try to use this, I would just stick to maybe horses in a field or like, you know, just like one type of thing. I wonder how it does with colors. Let's try to do something weird here. Maybe like pink cows. And we'll see what happens. Because cows aren't normally pink, but I'm wondering if it'll actually make a video of pink cows. Yeah. Pink cows. Not really moving. Like their spots are moving, but like their heads aren't really moving. So. Let's see, what else can we do? One thing from the demo I noticed, it seems to do good at like the type of shot and like, you know, if you want like golden hour. So maybe something with golden hour in it. Let's do close up shot of a plant next to a window at golden hour sunset. Wow. Yeah, it did a really nice job. Yeah, you see the window? It's a close-up shot of a plant next to a window at sunset. I can really see this, you know, instead of using a stock website for, you know, B-roll, you can generate your own very, you know, with specific prompts like, you know, close-up or sunset. Because, you know, if you stick to like stock websites, you know, you're limited to what's on there. But with using Runway, you can make it really customizable. Let's see how good it does with complex shots. Wide shot of a busy highway with several cars and a city skyline behind them. See how that does. We have 2 more prompts after this. Gotta choose wisely. Yeah, it didn't do bad. I think you could add more cars, but for the most part, it's not too bad. The highways look a little weird here in the center. It seems to struggle a little bit with shapes and like geometry a little bit. All right, let's try something where it would be hard to get stock footage of. Maybe like Antarctica or something. Ooh. Yeah, not bad. Kind of moving a little bit. They look a little funky, but not too bad, I would say. I think their heads are too big. Usually when I look at a penguin, it's like a small head and like big body type of thing. All right, so for the last one, let's try something with people in it maybe. Usually when I try to generate people, it doesn't do such a great job, but let's see how Runway does. Let's do office worker sitting next to a fish tank. Why not? Oh, that's interesting. Yeah, it's like their faces aren't that bad, to be honest. I'm kind of impressed with this, because a lot of the times AIs don't really do a good job at getting faces. I mean, his face kind of looks a little weird, but it's not like really badly morphed. I would say not a bad job. But I mean, when it comes to the fish tank idea, kind of put him in, and it looks like the next office next to him is like a fish tank, which is kind of interesting. And I noticed that I typed in office worker, but it did two office workers. So kind of like the numerical number was a little inaccurate, but I think this looks pretty good for especially being the first, you know, release of this generator. So that's Runaway's Gen 2. Let me know what you think down in the comments section below. I think overall it's a really good step, you know, for being one of the first text to video generators like this. I think, you know, obviously in the future it's going to get much better, but let me know what you think in the comments section below. But otherwise, thank you so much for watching. Feel free to like and subscribe if you want to see more video editing videos like this one.